Hello, and welcome to the Janet Annenberg Kirker Hall of Geology, Gems, and Minerals at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History. Thank you for joining us on this virtual tour. My name is Julie Hoskin. I'm a collection manager here at the museum, and I am so excited to share some of the hall with you today. Where do we come from? How did our planet form? How do we know about the history of our solar system? You can explore these universal questions in the Moon, Meteorite, and Solar System Gallery. Earth's story begins with the birth of the solar system more than 4.6 billion years ago. Our planet is a byproduct of the sun's formation from a vast cloud of dust and gas. There aren't a lot of clues left on Earth about its early life because plate tectonics and erosion have erased them. But meteorites, extraterrestrial rocks that land on Earth, provide an extraordinary opportunity to piece together the story of our planet. Meteorites are leftovers from the solar system's formation, and they record the history of that process. Most of them come from the asteroid belt located between the orbits of Jupiter and Mars and survive the fiery fall through the atmosphere to land on Earth. Where do we find meteorites? Deserts like Antarctica or the Sahara are great candidates because their dry environment preserves meteorites from weathering. In fact, more meteorites have been discovered in Antarctica than anywhere else on Earth because they are very easy to spot against the ice. Also, moving glaciers concentrate them in a few small areas, which makes the search easier. A few meteorite falls have been recorded on camera, and although they are very spectacular to watch, they are also extremely uncommon. One famous example is the Lost City meteorite fall in 1970. Which was recorded by the cameras of the Smithsonian Astrophysical Observatory. Meteorites are rarely found in inhabited areas, and even more rarely do they actually land on people. Some of these historical meteorite falls are on display in the hall. It can be very tricky to recognize a meteorite from a terrestrial rock. Some have a fusion crust, a thin black coating formed as the meteorite passed through Earth's atmosphere. The fusion crust can look similar to the weathering of an Earth rock. Others are metallic and dense because they are formed of iron and nickel metal. Melted chunks of industrial metal, referred to as slag, are often mistaken for meteorites. Ultimately, it is the meteorite's chemical composition, carefully measured in a laboratory, that is the best evidence of their extraterrestrial origin. There are different types of meteorites, and each type is a record of a different natural process. Some meteorites are fragments of asteroids that grew hot enough to melt and separate into several layers, core, mantle, and crust. Iron meteorites are core fragments, while stony meteorites are mantle or crust fragments. Some stony meteorites contain chondrules, which are formed from the original interstellar gas and dust cloud from which planets were assembled. Meteorites found on Earth typically range between the size of a pebble and a fist. When larger ones fall on a planetary body, such as Earth or the Moon, they leave an impact crater. Meteor Crater in Arizona was blasted out by a 45 meters wide meteorite traveling more than 40,000 kilometers per hour through space. A powerful impact such as this one also happened on the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico, leaving a crater of 150 kilometers in diameter, the second largest crater on the planet. This impact was so big that it created a cloud of dust in the atmosphere that later was redeposited across the globe in a thin layer preserved in the rock record. This layer is called the Cretaceous Tertiary or KT boundary layer and provides evidence of what contributed to the extinction of 70% of all species 66 million years ago, including the dinosaurs. Scientists at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History study meteorites big and small, from measuring their chemical composition at the scale of an atom in a laboratory to running complex models of the formation of our solar system. The museum's meteorite collection contains more than 17,000 specimens of more than 9,000 distinct meteorites. Scientists from around the world come to the museum to study them and unlock the mysteries of our universe.